Morning students, let's start with tutorial 3, which is on K maps. Okay, the first one was problem was plot the Boolean expression y is equal to ab plus bc ab plus ab bar plus bc and minimize the expression from the K map. Okay, so you got to plot it on the K map. Okay, so here if you see in the class we had taken a on the y axis and bc on the x axis. So here it has been just put in the other way around. So if you see now this is the mistake which we do even in the exams, which most of you will likely to do. If I give you an expression like this, you will plot ab here, a into b somewhere here, okay, you have to expand this to find out what are the min terms, each of these terms, because it is not in the canonical form, right? Some min terms are not directly visible here, right? So you have to expand this into the min canonical forms, only then the K map will be complete. Like AB will be ABC, there is no C here, so you need to include an C plus C bar. So the first term will become ABC plus ABC bar. Okay, so those two, ABC will be 7. So if you see here, it is M0, M1, M2, M3, right? Then M4, M5, M6 and M7. So M7. Then ABC bar. ABC bar will be, 4 plus 2, 6. So here, right? So that has come here. Now AB bar is, again you have to AB bar C plus C plus C bar, you got to include here, right? C plus C bar, so it will be AB bar, right? And then C, or you can do that from here also, AB bar and C, you're putting a 1 here, then AB bar and C bar, so A B bar and C bar, so you put a 1 here also, right? Then BC is BCA, so A is here and BC, again you got to multiply it with A plus A bar, so BCA and BCA bar, so you have BC and A bar, you put a 1 out here, right? So then you make a K map out of it. So these are the now 4 which is there. Okay, I stressed in the class also, if there is a 1 out here all alone, you should not make an single grouping. If it is, although this one is already covered by this, but we can make a bigger box out here, so we will take a bigger box out like this. Okay, so if you don't see, you will see what is the disadvantage having in a single box. If you have a single box, what will be the expression? It will be BC A bar, right? So the final answer will be A plus BC A bar, right? If you make a box like this, what will be the answer? It will be A and it will be just BC. So that if you are going to make a single box here and leave this, it will just cause a redundancy, which will just give you one more element out here. So you will have to always see that and make the biggest possible box, okay, and of 2 or 4 like that. So you just have to do that, so these are the small, be careful with the expressions like this. If you get an expression here, just remember you have to add an C plus C bar here. Here also C plus C bar, A plus A bar. Don't try to just map an AB. So that is common mistakes which we do, right? Okay, now using K map, so the min terms are given here, 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 4, 5. So once the min term is given, it becomes pretty easy, right? So for this is a standard way of writing the MSB here and the LSB as C. Okay, so we know how the min terms come, right? In the class also attend 1, M0, M1 and then outermost M3, because it's a gray code. So M0, M1, M2 and then it comes inside M3. Similarly, it starts from M4, M5, then M6 is the outermost one and then M7 is the second one from the right. So these are swapped. So just remember that M0, M1, M3, M4, M0, M1, M2, M3, then M4, M5, M6 is outside and M7 is inside. So 10145. So M0, M1, M4, M5. So you just group it together. Okay. So I think if you get some questions, you are going to get some questions like this. So it is pretty simple, right? Very simple to make it here. So here, okay. So the final answer for this would be, what is the final answer for this? Anybody? Anyone? Yeah, it is just B bar. Yeah, the solution is B bar only. Okay, so final answer will be B bar. Okay. Yeah, tell me. Yeah. Correct. F equal to no, that's a max term. Max term is giving you when the function is going to be low. Correct. So so it will give B. Essentially, it means whenever it is B, it will be low. Yeah. Minimizing the K-map, again there is one more K-map example. So I think if you listen carefully here, your preparation for exam is over, I guess. Okay, so M equal to 0146, there are the four minterms. So M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. So M0, M1 is written here, M4 is written here, M6 is the outermost, M7 is the inner one which is there. So what are the groupings? What kind of groupings can we do? Can somebody tell? Yeah, correct. So total how many groupings can we do? Three. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So this will be the expression for the top red one. What would be the expression for the top red one? Yeah. Okay. If you just try to analyze this, I'm telling you, your preparation for your K-map exam will be over. Okay. What about this? Yeah, AB. What about this vertical one? We are going to neglect. It is not required. So what about these two outer ones? A C bar. Okay. So many of you might have encountered unwanted spikes in your simulation. Most of you. Have you encountered unwanted spikes? Yeah. So don't confuse for the exam, but the spikes will be caused if we leave some of these boxes like this. Okay, not necessarily this, like these one. So we will learn. I'm just giving a hint. Okay, we'll learn it next week. Okay. So if you see a transition from here to here. Right, adjacent ones sometimes we leave, not all adjacent box will cause spikes, but if we leave some of the adjacent box, it will cause spikes. So when we learn about these spikes issue in detail in that class, so we'll see which are those additional boxes which we need to incorporate to avoid the spikes. From the K-map, we'll be able to make where all there will be spikes and all. Okay, so don't do it for the present exam. I'm just giving a hint. Okay, so later on. No. It is a full representation. Okay, this is a full representation. There won't be any problem with the function with this. only in the dynamic behavior there will be small spikes which we can avoid, so that suppose there is a one here also, you don't have to club all the ones. Certain boxes will create problem. We'll learn how they are going to create problem, because I get lot of questions on these spikes. That's why I just wanted to, anyway, we'll cover that in detail in the class. Okay, so for the exam point of view, for the time being, this is the minimized expression, that's all. Okay, yeah, tell me. Yeah. Yeah. Correct. In this question, is it? Question number 2. Max terms, this is, yeah, this is a 4, no? You get a B, right? Okay. No. On the first row, it will be, say there are only 2 terms, and if you have, if there is no zeros here, only there are 2 zeros here, and if you have to make a max term, then it will be these 2, right? It will be A or B bar. A or B bar, and this will be A bar into A bar into B bar, and then you multiply it, you will get B, right? Correct. You try to do it as a min term. You have to be careful with that, huh? If it is max terms, okay. For all of you, just can you read out what would be the max term for this, so that, you know, we are clear about the max term representation also. If only 2 zeros are here, what will be the max term? Anybody? A plus. Yeah, A plus B bar. What about this? A bar plus B bar. Okay, correct. Okay, so just be and then if you have 2 such zeros here and here, then we put an AND in between, not an OR. Okay, so just, yeah, it will be B bar only. It will. No, this will be B. Yeah, 0. One corresponds to B bar, right? Yeah. Correct. Yeah, correct. Max and implementation also, will give you an B bar only. Correct. Because see, there is if only there are 2 terms, then you will have an AND gate which is coming in the end, right? OR gate. Here it is giving the direct expression, so it will continue to remain B bar only, right? Finally, the min term is to be implemented physically, right? So whether it is max term or min term, it will be implemented as B bar. So one inverter will be required. Either you use one NAND gate and short both the inputs, or you use a NOR gate. So the expression would be B bar only, final output. Yeah. Correct. My mistake. Yeah. Yeah, any way you implement, either with min term or max term, the final output has to be the same, right? Only thing is, here zeros we will consider as 1, and we make an OR gate, and then subsequently put an AND gate. But what finally comes out will be the function f only in both cases. Okay. Yeah. Did we do this? I think we have done this. Okay. Okay. Now this is one more with an four variable k map it is. So the minterms are given 0, 2, 5, 7, 8. So you understood the logic like here, right? This is m0, m1, m2 and then m3, then m4, m5, m6 and m7. Okay. And then you go to the last row. Okay. Because it's a gray code on the y axis also. So you m8, m9. M10 and then M11, okay, and then M12, M13, M14 and M4. Once you know, you do one example and you put it into your mind the way the minterms is written, then everything falls into place. Okay, so then you just tick the minterms. 0 is there here, right, and 2 is here. See, 2 will be in the outermost one. Then 5, 7, 8, 10, 13 and 15. So you can make two boxes. So can somebody read what would be this one expression for the red one? It will be Q and S. Okay, you just have to see what are the variables which are not varying. Okay, so it's Q here and it's S here. And about the corner four ones, yeah, Q dash S dash. So you have an N. So now if I have to implement this, right, so I'll have an two input AND gates and one OR gate, right, and obviously one NOT gates each for this in case the complementary is not available. So this is how we finally, this requires to be made into a gate implementation, right? So you might have in practical life, if you see, there might be four different inputs. Okay, one could be coming from your temperature, one could be from your humidity, okay, one could be some power supply and all. So based on the user says, okay, if the temperature is so and so, something should switch on. So you make expression based on that. You make these minterm conditions from the user whatever has gained. Then you make an K map, you get an expression, and from the expression you need to finally, this is not the end, right, from the expression you need to know how to make a digital circuit finally, okay, using NAND NOR implementation. So that's the full chain of design. Okay, this is one example for the max terms. Okay, so max terms are 0, 1, 5, 7, 8. So we make 0, 1, right, and 5, and then 7, 8, okay, 8, 9, and 15. Okay, so these are to be mapped exactly the way minterms are mapped. So there is no variation here. Okay, only thing is we are going to write zeros wherever it is. So what are the essential boxes here? Can anybody tell? How many boxes are required? One of the blue will be. So either this blue, among the two blue, only one will be required. Okay, so what would be the expression for these two, which is C and inverted C boxes? B plus C. Okay, and what about these two? Yeah. Okay, so you have to remember, if you in a 4k variable, this thing, if you are making a 4 box, it will have 2 variables. If you have a 2 box, there will be 3 variables. So for these two, there will be 2 different solutions. Both will be correct, right? So either you can have these two or these two, right? So anybody, if you have got any doubts with this, So, no, you don't have to study extra, I guess. If you are clear with these things, this portion will be, okay for your exams. Just be clear how. Okay, okay. I'll just open up my theory slides once, and once this is over, we will go back there. Okay. Okay. Nahi, can you repeat your question, please? हाँ. या दैट्स इट. नो, इफ इट इज डिफरेंट इट्स ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. ओके, हु आस्क्ड अबाउट प्राइम एंड दिस थिंग्स, प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स? या, यू मे जस्ट स्किप द प्राइम इम्प्लीमेंट फॉर टाइम बीइंग. ओके, वील अगेन रिविजिट द प्राइम एंड दिस थिंग इन द क्यूएम मेथड. ओके, इन इट वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस जस्ट, बट इन के मैप्स वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू यूज दैट. ओके, द एंटायर थिंग विल बी रिपीटेड फॉर योर है ना दिस थिंग क्यूएम मेथड ऑन सैटरडे अगेन. ओके, सो इफ यू आर गेटिंग कन्फ्यूज फॉर द एग्जाम, जस्ट लीव दैट पोर्शन असाइड, इट्स नॉट देयर फॉर योर एग्जाम. ओके, विल हैंडल इट ऑन सैटरडे क्लास अगेन, वंस अगेन. The entire thing will be repeated there. Okay. So, yeah, Rahul, I had given don't care examples in the class. You are from P1 or P2? Rahul? Okay. ओके, दिस इज ना मिनिमाइज केयर, डोंट केयर, दिस आर द डोंट केयर कंडीशंस. सो आई एक्सप्लेन, आई गेव यू सम लाइव एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ डोंट केयर, राइट? वन इज दैट एडीसी एग्जाम्पल विच आई डिस्कस्ड इन द क्लास, वेयर इफ यू हैव एन एडीसी, सर्टन इनपुट्स विल नेवर बी अवेलेबल. सिमिलरली, वेन यू आर हैविंग ए बीसीडी आउटपुट, driving an 7 segment display, so the output from the BCD will be only 0 to 9. Rest of the elements will never come. So you might have don't care conditions, right? So those are the don't care. So in real time applications, there will be many a times where there will be don't care. So you don't, those conditions will never occur in the input because of the very nature of the, see, all these variables we are taking it from the real life, right? So there may be some conditions which will never occur in the real life scenario at all. So they will be, so you don't have to cater for that and try to make a K map. So you can, if those conditions are not likely to come at all, then you might as well use it as a don't care and simplify your design further. So that is what we do. So if somebody has missed out, you can just go through that portion of my theory class if you are from L2, where I have given some live examples of don't care conditions. I had discussed about an ADC, and also I can show that slide towards the end of the class also. Okay. So, coming with trying to solve this don't care conditions. So, you have an 0 set 0, 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1 set 2, 3, 4, 6, 11, 12, and don't care sets 10, 12, and 14. Okay. So, we have don't cares here, okay, at these minterm positions. Okay. So, now when we try to make these boxes, okay, don't care can be used to our advantage. We can make a box, we can use that to simplify our expressions, either it be for max term or min term. It can be clubbed along with the one. So in this case, if you see these, without this don't care, we would have made these two ones as a two box and these two ones as a two box. But since we have a don't care here, we can make a single big box out here, right? Similarly, when this don't care, so we can make a single big box by taking these two and these two together, right? So it simplifies the expression. But you don't have to, cater for every don't care which is there in the box. Okay. So in this case, we don't require these don't care, this one. Okay. It is not going to help us. So we should not try and make this one an x also. So don't care means it is a joker. It can be either be 0 or a 1. So we will assume, okay, we can assign this as an 0. So it doesn't matter when we make an hardware. So automatically those conditions will not be there. When those inputs don't come, so we can put a the final output will be once only for those specific input conditions only what we require. So that is not going to spoil our final output. Okay. So that is how don't cares can be used to further minimize the circuit. Is it clear? Anybody has got any doubt? Here, is it clear? Okay. So we can make this here. Okay, this is for again, if there are zeros also, we can do that. So it's the same maxim. If you are taking the max terms, if you see don't care condition here. Okay, these two zeros, top two zeros, and can be clubbed into one. So we have a don't care here. So we can utilize that to make a bigger max term, more simplified max term. So you can group that, you can take that x also as zero, and we can assign, assume these are going to be one here. So we will do that. Okay. So this is one more expression, right? Okay. Then design a circuit which has an 5-bit binary ABC, A being the MSE. It must produce for any prime detected in the input data, right? So if the input is a prime number, it should give an output as one. So we have to. This is a 5-variable K-map. Okay, so if it is a 5K variable, so what are the prime numbers which are available between 0 and 31? So these are the prime numbers: m1, m2, m3, m5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, and 31. Right? So this is now. Tell me. All the prime numbers requires to be, yeah. This I have picked up this from some textbook where they have considered M1 also as an prime number. Okay. Okay, with the terminology, how? Okay, we will be more bothered about how we are going to implement these things. Okay, so I explained you three methods of doing a five variable map in the theory class. Here it's gray code mirror image one, which is used to solve this particular exam. Example. Okay, so it is how will the minterms will be placed? Okay, this is also pretty simple. Okay, it m0, m1, m2, m3, and then you start from here, from the rightmost, m4, m5, m6, and m7, right? So you have first m1 and m2, m1, m2, m3, then m4 is not there, m5 is there. Right, M6 is not there, M7 is there, right? Then coming to M8, M9, M10, M11. So M11 is here. Okay, M12, M13. So this is M13. M14, M15, right? Then M17, M16, M17, M18 is blank, M19 is here, M20, M21. M22, M23. Okay, then you come to the third row M24 25 26 20 24 25 26 and 27 28 29 is there, 30 31. Okay, you make here. Now you see even the mirrors can be clubbed. So if first within one table, if you see, there is one red out here and this is the mirror image. So you have 1 2 and 3 4. Can you just tell what would be the answer for that on the top four reds? Anybody? A bar, B bar, and if you see E is one out here, and here also E is one here. So it is A bar and B bar E. Okay. Similarly, you have these two ones and these two ones here, right? So it will, this also you have, you can make a combination of four, right? So what would be the combination for this? B bar C bar E, correct. Okay, now if you see these two ones and these two ones, they are not the mirrors of each other. Okay, if you write that form of first taking A equal to 0 and A equal to 2 independent K maps, in that method you will see okay if they are the same. In this method, since it is a gray code method, this is not a reflection of this, right, along this axis. So they are different here, so they are not the mirror image. So these are going to be this have to be written differently. Similarly, all these 2 2 2 squares are all different. If you can just quickly read out each one of you, so that we know we get prepared for the exam also. So what about this, these two? Anybody? Yeah, correct. So similarly, okay, so these solutions are written here. I'll share this PPT, so just go through this, so that as a five variable is not there for the exam, but you got the hint, right? So there are three methods in the class we discussed. So this is one of the methods where the way we depict these figures are different for the three. So whichever you are comfortable, you can use. There is one. Yeah, correct. So across the mirror here, right? And if it is a six variable, you will make one more mirror and you will flip it down also. There will be one more going like this. Okay. So you can have top down mirror also. So it will be like this, right? So there. Yeah. No, I didn't. Yeah, these two ones. Yeah, twice towards the left. Yeah. Okay. Then. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Here we can club. If you have a one here and one here. Yeah, they are mirror. You can club that. So here we, as we move from here to here, they're symmetrical. Right? We can do that. Okay. Yeah. 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 Okay. Okay. No, we will have to actually implement and see, you know, how much of hardware that takes and whatever, you know, how much of hardware, you know, other many a times it is possible that, you know, we apply a different algorithm, we land up with, you know, a simpler solution. Okay, these are the set of rules which an layman need not think. Okay, it is a streamlined procedure for any given input method. This is how we do, and we get an expression. Okay, but many a times, like human can think beyond that, right? This is an okay. These are the if these are the things. This is the procedure you follow. You will get an expression. Okay, so and the one advantage with this is it will give in the standard format for implementation in hardware also. But you might have still an optimized version than this by applying your own logic, right? So there is no logic, because that is specific to each problem. It will be different, that logic what you are applying, right? It is not a universal method. So it is possible, right? So if you have full adders and many of the optimized full adders at the transistor level I am speaking. So people have suggested, okay, this is the most optimized version, and it is, since full adder is a 28 transistor adder, but if you try to do it with KMAP, it will be more, it will use more than that. Okay, so but that whosoever has given that solution, that is specific to that, but for a full adder only. Okay, that method cannot be implemented across the board for all circuits. So whenever human being and human element is involved, many times you will get a more optimized solution also than what an algorithm would do. Okay, but only problem is algorithm will be universal, human intervention solutions will be specific to a problem. It can be more optimized than this. Okay, so let me take some doubts. Okay, now what were the doubts? Yeah. Yeah, tell me. Okay. Yeah. Somebody wanted to know about prime implicants and essential prime implicants. Let me go back. Let me just close this presentation. Okay, so we'll call off this tutorial here, and we'll take on as a rest of the thing as a doubt session. Okay, so this is an example of an typical don't care condition. Okay, so this is an here it's wrong, written wrong top on the top. It should be analog to digital converter. Okay, it's written back out here. So it takes an analog input. Okay, the analog input is given to the three comparators. Okay, and these three comparators, you have an suppose it is in a so let's assume that analog signal is changing from 0 to 10 volts. Okay, so what we have given is, we have given 1/4 of V, that is 2.5 volt reference here, 5 volt reference here, and 7.5 volt reference here. So when these comparators will give an high signal, whenever the input signal is more than 2.5 volt, this will give a high signal. Whenever this analog input signal gives goes beyond 5 volt, this is going to give a high. And whenever the analog signal goes beyond 7.5 volt, this is going to give an high. So if you see, it is a 3-bit. These are all digital outputs, right? It will be either 0 or 1. Whereas this is an analog input. So you have 3-bit information, right? So for this 3-bit information, what are the total possible combinations? Yeah, Rahul, can you tell me? For 3-bit, what is the maximum number of input combinations? 8, right? Huh? 3-bit means 8 combinations is possible. But in this practical scenario, how many combinations will be there? Right, if the signal is anything below 2.5, it will be 0. If it is between 2.5 and 5 volt, the signal will be you know, if I take this as MSB, C3 as MSB, it will be 001. If it is going beyond 5, right, it will be 011. And if it is going beyond 7.5, the signal will be 111. So you will see that only 4 combinations are available, right? So there are 4 combinations output, and in fact there will be 5 when the signal is if the signal is below 2.5, it will be all zeros also, I think, right? 0, then all zeros, 001, 011, and then 111. I think 4 combinations. Okay, so rest of the 4 will become don't care conditions when you are designing this circuit, because I know, okay, those conditions can never occur, right? So then you can make an design. This is again, you can reduce it with the K-map also. Okay, it is shown out here. Okay, somebody had asked a question. Okay, sir, is the K-map, see this is again a specific. So if I do it with a K-map, I'll surely get an answer, but that will not be the this somebody has done it using human intervention, not with the K-map. So he has put an XOR gate and 2 AND gate. So it is an more optimized solution because of human. This is not made by the, but if you can make a K-map, it will give a solution. And if you see an XOR gate, K-map doesn't give an XOR gate, right? But from the final expression, if you see, you can club some of the expressions. If it is A bar B plus B bar A, you can replace that with an XOR gate, right? So that is how some optimization has been done here. So that answers one of other query also, and you see how the don't cares have come, right? So this is another example of don't care, right? It is a BCD input, so you have to design this inside this. Now we know it, you have to drive an LCD. So what are the inputs which can come here? If we have learnt about BCD adder also, right? The output of a BCD adder will always be between 0 and 9 only. It can't go. So you can have all inputs from 10 to 15, you can make it as a don't care. So when we design this IC, so since we know it takes 4 BCD input and gives and drive for a 7 bit output for driving and 7 segment display, this cannot go beyond 9. So from 10 to 15 we can take it as a don't care. Okay, so this is another example of don't care, right? Then the question was about prime implicants, right? Let me see where is those slides. Okay, what an implicant means is if there is a function, okay, all of these will become implicants. That means if AB is high, irrespective of all other terms, if AB is high, F is high. So any combination of inputs which will if it is high and the function f also is going to be high because that particular combination becoming high, then that combination can be called as an implicant, right? That is called as an implicant. So here AB is an implicant, ABC is an implicant, BC also is an implicant. Okay, so this is not a min term. Okay, if you expand it, there will be 2 min terms here, right? So this AB, we call it as implement. So these are all implicants, individually these, right? Now if you come to the second issue of what is a prime implicant. So when we map the into a K map, when we make a K map, each possible box, okay, each possible becomes a prime implicant. Okay, now if you see this one, if I consider only this minterm, each minterm is an implicant. Okay, each of these minterms individually, they can be called as an implicant, because if this particular function, what will this function will be A bar, B bar, C bar. So A bar, C bar, A bar, B bar, C bar is an implicant, because when that goes high, the function also goes high. So that's an implicant. But when we group it into K maps, okay, then these functions, they are known as the prime implicants. Okay, this is an from the simple implicants we come to a prime implicant. Prime implicant is only the all possible boxes. All possible boxes are known as prime implicant, and from prime implicant we go to something known as essential prime implicants. Okay, so this is a redundant one, right? So this is a redundant one. So even without this, the function can be implemented, but without this, the function cannot be implemented without this, so without this prime implicant. So these becomes the essential prime implicants. Okay, so this is, and the one which is shown here, okay, which we have left out, that becomes the non-essential or redundant prime implicants. So is it clear what are the implicants? Four types of: just implicant, prime implicant, essential prime implicant, and redundant implicant. Is it clear, everybody? Yeah, okay. So that's all for today. So today's class will be a doubt session. Okay, so whatever doubts, and if you have some time, and all the doubts will be taken care of in this session. I don't want to introduce a new topic at this point of time and clutter your thoughts before the exams, and that's the reason I'm leaving it as a doubt clause. Now that's, if somebody has got any issue with Xilinx installation, and you can come up during that hour, you can present your screen and we'll resolve that issue, because Xilinx is also pretty interesting software. You will learn a lot of new things in Xilinx also, because your hands will not be tied up with limited number of ICs. It's a Verilog code, so you can explore a lot of new things. Okay, so in any case, if somebody has got any problem with the installation in Xilinx, can present your thing in your class. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks a lot.